My great-grandfather, Santora, is the one who greets everybody when they walk in the door.
Black and white photos on the walls are lingering reminders of the original Iozzo's Garden of Italy. But here, Katie Harris has been carrying on her family's tradition for the last 10 years. However, she had to get her grandmother's blessing first.
And she goes, Katie, do you have to tell the story? I go, Grandma, if we don't, somebody else will.
The story involved a bar brawl, murder trial, and salacious headlines in the early 1940s, which led her family to close their doors for 70 years. But in this historic 1880s building, with an intimate courtyard and Venetian glasswork, Harris has written a new chapter in Iozzo family history, and it's as tasty as ever. And that's because they use the same family recipes as the original restaurant.
Our meatballs are hand-rolled in-house every single day. Veal, pork, and beef slow-cooked in sauce. And then our family Iozzo sauce is slow-cooked on the stove about four times a week here with pork spare ribs, and it just kind of smells of my grandmother's kitchen.
Other top-selling menu items include pesto-crusted scallops with goat cheese, lasagna bolognese, featuring both bolognese and Alfredo sauces on top, and desserts like their Italian cream cake that you can finish with an espresso or sip on Iozzo's homemade limoncello or their family-inspired wine.
We go out to California every year and make wine for the restaurant. So we just actually got in our new third wine in our heritage collection, named after my great aunt Mary.
While on the Old South Side, check out these other popular locally owned businesses: Shapiro's, Greek Islands, and the Scarlet Lane Old South Side Tap House.